Yo, what's going on YouTube? It is your boy Ears. Hope you guys are having a great rest of your day, start to your day, whatever time it may be. And I'll be going over how you guys can get more kills, get your streaks a lot faster, as well as set up a solo spawn trap on the map Shoot House. Let me know down in the comment section right now, what is the next map that you guys want me to do a map breakdown on, where I go over all the spawns, all the power positions, and also all the callouts for that specific map. This is the class that I was using on Shoot House. I was using the PP19 Bison with the Monolith Suppressor, the 8.7-inch steel barrel, which allows me to have increased damage range, increased bullet velocity, as well as increased recoil control. I'm running the rubberized grip tape, so I have additional recoil control as well. The no stock attachment, so I can have increased movement speed and also faster aim down sight speed, which is key on Shoot House because speed and agility is what you guys want to be aiming for when you guys are trying to get more kills, your streaks faster, and also rotate the spawns so you can set up a solo spawn trap. And then finally, I am running the fully loaded perk, so I never run out of ammo, because running out of ammo is probably the worst thing that can happen when you guys are going for your score streaks, your kill streaks, or maybe even a tactical nuke. Now, if you guys enjoy the best class of the videos and the gameplay breakdowns on the channel, make sure you guys absolutely smash like button the video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on those post notifications so you guys stay up to date and notified immediately when I upload a new video. And with all being said, let's jump right into the gameplay breakdown. Alright, so if you guys are playing on Shoot House, you guys are spawning in on the C domination side, you're going to want to make sure you guys are pushing through this shipping containers area here. Now, I take out this enemy here, and I actually get taken out by somebody lying down on that box head glitch. Keep a mental note, whenever this match first starts off, whenever you guys are playing any match of Shoot House, players are going to be camping in the back of their spawn to try to take out your team, try to take you out so they can get their streaks early on so they can gain map control. This is what you guys do not want to have happen. Your objective when playing on Shoot House is to actually get into their spawn and get your streaks as fast as possible so you yourself and your team can gain map control and to stop the camping from happening before it does. Now, this Maniac Mike player was actually camping incredibly hard this entire game. Now, like I said, you want to keep a mental note where these players are camping at. Now, again, I spawn in on the shipping container side, and I'm going to be making that rush route again to try to kind of flush out their team from lying in the back. Again, I take out this player here. I immediately have that mental note to check that spot, come around the corner, and again, I get taken out by Maniac Mike lying down next to another box head glitch. Unfortunately, this is how a lot of players play on Shoot House, but once you kind of flush these guys out of their spawn, once you start rotating and also gaining map control, as well as your teammates getting map control because of the streaks in the air, you will be able to take over this map. In this gameplay, I actually dropped 120 kills with a tactical nuke, and that happened very promptly after I gained map control and got my streaks up in the air. I'm gonna be explaining how you guys can actually do that and also set up a solo spawn trap later on in this gameplay breakdown. So again, I get taken out by Maniac Mike. Now, he actually plays a very important part in this gameplay. Because of the way he's playing, I'm automatically gonna assume that, okay, since he's kinda anchoring for his team, they're all gonna be spawning on him. Now, I can use this to my advantage. Now, whenever you guys are playing on Shoot House and you guys are noticing that people are lying down in corners, they're lying down in the back end of the map, you want to keep a mental note that the other enemy team is going to be spawning on that player a lot. They're going to be wave spawning on those players. Now, you can use this to your advantage because you could take out 4 or 5, maybe even their entire team at a very short period of time, allowing you to get your score streaks or your kill streaks a lot faster. Now, you guys can see here that I'm running the kill streak setup of the precision airstrike. I'm also running the VTOL jet, and I'm also running the advanced UAV. Now, whenever I'm playing on this map, I always throw my precision airstrike in the middle of the map. I want to stop them from actually pushing through middle map. Now, what you're going to be seeing me do in this entire gameplay is I'm actually running the outskirts of this map. You can set up a solo spawn trap by doing this method. Never push middle map unless you have an advanced UAV and you guys need to get to the enemy team as fast as possible to either get more kills or maybe even try to go ahead and get your tactical nuke. Now, I put my precision airstrike in that position to kind of push the enemies out from pushing through middle map, because I do not want them to kind of mess my team up, because right now we are down on the hard points. Now, right now, I'm not really playing the hardpoint objective because I need to get my score streaks as fast as possible. I can see that Maniac Mike is lying down in the back of the spawn. I see that he's camping, and I do not want him to get streaks off my team because he's lying down and camping in the back of the map. Now, right here, you guys can see here that I am pushing and influencing the hard point, and the enemy team is going to be spawning in on the junkyard area of the map. Now, I want to rewind this position, this part of the gameplay right here. Now, whenever they are spawning in on junkyard, their immediate next spawn is going to be shipping containers, where I actually made that first push. Now, you need to keep a mental note on where you guys are killing enemies on this map, because that's exactly how you're going to set up a solo spawn trap. Again, I take out that player here on the hard point, and three players are running from junkyard, and I take out these two guys here and then another at junkyard. Now, because I took those players out, I jump the corner, I take another player, I'm immediately going to be hitting this jump wall. You guys can see here, they all spawn shipping containers. You can kind of rotate the outskirts of the map and catch them before they actually kind of get their bearings and understand what's actually happening to them. Now, unfortunately, I get taken out by an Odin. The Odin's incredibly good, so you're going to be worried about, you know, shotguns. But for the most part, you guys can see that the spawn trap is tight. The spawn trap is solid. It's very easy to rotate on this map because it is so small. It's very easy to predict the spawns. Now, the other positions where they could be spawning in at after they get taken out on junkyard, depending on where your team is at, is either back A or back C. We're gonna get into that later on in this video. Now, again, I'm taking out these players here. They're spawning in on the A side. I take out Maniac Mike as well, kind of fanning in and out. And again, I thought they actually spawned right there because my teammate messed me up, and I took out that player that was actually, you know, running back to the old hardpoint. I don't really know what he was doing right there. I see that he's actually pushing through junkyard, and another player actually spawned in on junkyard as well. Now, right here, I'm kind of playing for my advanced UAV. I want to get my advanced UAV as fast as possible. Again, I know they're going to be spawning in back C because I cleared out the hard. I cleared out junkyard, and the hardpoint is also on shipping containers. The enemy team is never going to spawn in on the hardpoint. That's just not how it's going to work here in Modern Warfare. They fix the spawns, especially on hardpoint. So whenever the hardpoint is on shipping containers, they're going to be either spawning in on junkyard, back A, or back C. So you can kind of keep in mind where the spawns are at. Because of that, you can kind of set up that solo spawn trap that way. When the hardpoint is in junkyard, they're only going to be spawning in on shipping containers, back A, as well as back C. Where I am right now, I'm actually going to rewind the gameplay so you guys can understand. Where I am right now, this is going to be the back A spawn of, you know, Shoot House. And where I actually crossed previously, the other side of the map is going to be back C. Those are going to be the four major spawn points on this map. Again, I am pushing through this position here, and I'm pushing from the back end of the hard point, and I actually come up behind two other guys that are on the hill. Now, I actually get my advanced UAV here, and now you need to keep in mind and keep a mental note of where they're spawning at. Because I pushed and influenced that hill, they started spawning in on the shipping the back kind of A spawn, as well as the junkyard. Now, again, the hardpoint hill is in junkyard, and look where they're spawning at. They're spawning in on back C, as well as the shipping containers area. It's very easy to predict the spawns, and you don't really even need an advanced UAV on this map. You guys kind of see exactly how players are kind of rotating and how you guys can set up the solo spawn trap. So if you guys are getting like destroyed on Shoot House and you're not understanding how the enemies are getting into your spawn so fast, this is exactly what they're doing. They're keeping a mental note of where the spawns are at, and you kind of rotate and use that to your advantage. So again, like I said, I have the advanced UAV. I see that they're spawning in on shipping, and now that they're kind of rotating through back A, so now they're definitely going to be influenced on shipping containers. Right here, I'm just picking them off from this head glitch. This car head glitch is absolutely incredible. These guys actually got incredibly smart. You guys can see here that they're actually starting to use smoke grenades, so I have to be very wary of that. Now, I'm pushing through here. I'm pushing through the back A spawn. Take him out, and right there, unfortunately, I got taken out by somebody that got a fluke spawn middle map. Now, whatever this is in Modern Warfare, I don't understand how this happens. There's always a couple spawn points on this game where the enemies just pop up out of nowhere. Now, I myself don't know how this happens, because if you guys play domination on some of the bigger maps, you guys will know that sometimes, even though nobody on your team is pushing up, they'll still spawn somebody behind you in a spot where they should not be at. This is one of those spots on this map. The guy literally spawned middle map in sight of me, literally saw me spawn or saw me run away from where he spawned in at, which is kind of weird. And again, I spawn in, jump on the jump wall, and I immediately take on another player that spawned in on that spawn point. I don't understand why players spawn there. I think it's just a random spawn influencer, and you have to kind of keep in mind, you know, where people are spawning at. Now right here, I have to rewind this. This is exactly what I'm talking about. I didn't even necessarily see this guy, but again, Maniac Mike again is literally lying down in the back of a spawn, just chilling in the back. I don't understand why people play like this. They spend $60 to lie down in the back of the map. Oh well, you could say he was watching the hard point, but I think we all can understand that this guy was just a certified camper. Again, I actually turn on him right there, and I get shot through a brick wall by an MP5. Whatever, game. I don't know how that happened. And then right there, I spawned directly behind that player. That was another fluke spawn. So sometimes you can't predict it, but it just happens. The spawns can be pretty crazy on Shoot House. And that's exactly why you need to keep a mental note of where you're spawning at and only push the outskirts of the map and stay away from the middle area of the map. You guys saw that I actually got taken out. The time that I died from behind was because I was actually pushing and trying to cut through middle map. Now again, I'm checking back C. I see that they're spawning in on the shipping containers again, so I'm rotating this side of the map. Now again, I'm going to be jumping over shipping containers. I'm making a risky play. I'm trying to cross middle map again, and again, as soon as I try to cross middle map, I almost got taken out. Now the hard point is in the center of the map, so the only spawns they could be spawning in when the hard point's on the center of the map is, again, it's going to be back A, back C, junkyard, as well as shipping containers. So right now I'm going to be pushing through junkyard to try to get behind the A spawn, because that is where I believe they're going to be spawning at. This teammate actually has a good idea as well. He actually pushed through middle map, but he actually was able to take that enemy out and take another guy out, so GG's to him. Now I'm pushing, like I said, back through A spawn to try to come through shipping containers, and right here I get fucking executed by Maniac Mike. This guy spawned inside of me. I don't understand how that happened, man. It just, like, it's crazy how this could play out. Again, the spawn is the hard points on middle map. I throw down my precision airstrike mid map, and I'm able to take some of them out. Now I push underneath here, take these guys out, and I decide at this point I'm just gonna push middle map. I don't know where they're at. I'm just kind of running around trying to get my bearings, and I see that they're actually spawning in on back A spawn. I got incredibly lucky here that these guys were not ready for me, and I took them out there. They probably did not suspect me to be spawning or to be running around in the area of the map. I see that, like I said, I took them out middle map, that they immediately spawned in on the junkyard. Now that they're now that the hard point is back C, they are spawning in on shipping containers, and they're pushing through mid. Like, I took them out there. I kind of slide that corner there. That teammate kind of scared me because I was not expecting him to be there. And again, right now, I'm going to be pushing through the shipping containers area of this map. Now again, I'm rotating back C because I know they're going to be spawning in over here. I see that there's another smoke grenade, so I decide, you know what, I'm just going to throw down my precision airstrike directly on the hill to kind of influence those spawns. And I'm also super close to my advance. I got super lucky right there. Now you guys can see right there, sometimes they will spawn them top control room. Now the only way they're going to be spawning them top control room is, I've noticed this, is if you guys have some type of VTOL jet up, if you guys have some type of support helo up, a chopper gunner up, and your teammates are occupying the junkyard area, you're spawning in on shipping containers, and your team is also pushed back C, they will spawn them top control, which is directly on top of me. That's the area where people like to camp at. So you guys need to keep a mental note that sometimes they will actually spawn up there. Again, it's one of those fluke spawn points where you just have to keep a mental note and kind of be wary of that. If you guys have streaks up and your teammates are influencing the spawns, that they actually might spawn on top of that area of the map. Now I pop my advance, and I see that because my team actually died, they're actually going to be spawning in back C and some of them are actually pushed up through shipping containers. Now I take these guys out here, and again, I decided to push middle map because I have my advanced UAV. I take out these two guys here. I decide to actually push through back A spawn, take this guy out as well, come up behind this player here, take him out, and I see that they're also, you know, continuously spawning into this area. They spawn directly behind me at back A. Got to be very wary. Right here, I thought I was a goner because their entire team, literally their whole team, spawned back A. That's exactly why. Whenever you guys are in a gunfight and you guys know you're going to lose, run. There's nothing wrong with it. I'm literally just bolting, running away. Like, three guys chasing me. I just had to run away, take out these guys here, and I'm able to get a quick and easy four-piece, and I'm already on a brutal because of that play. Right here, guys, here. I got incredibly lucky right there. I don't know how I was able to survive that gunfight. Obviously, some of these guys in this lobby were not the best, but regardless, that was such a clutch and lucky play. Now, right here, again, I see that my teammates are kind of, you know, they're kind of by back A, but some of them also by shipping containers. So I see that they're going to be spawning in behind me at back A, and also there's one guy shipping. Now, the hard point immediately flipped to the junkyard. Now, I'm on 29 kills right here. The clutchest kill of my life. I get the turn on for the tactical nuke, man. Alright, that was dirty. If you guys have not dropped a like already on the video, make sure you guys absolutely smash the like button for that, man. That was a play of the fucking century, as well as also subscribe to the channel and turn on those post notifications. I think that play deserves it, man. That was a disgusting turn on for that tactical nuke. I was honestly screaming when I actually got that because I was in the zone. Now pushing again through back A, and right here, since we have like a minute left, I'm like, all right, I'm gonna go for a gun streak, or maybe, you know, just kind of just mess around, see if I get a little bit more kills. Pick up this AK-74U, and I get immediately taken out. The 74U is garbage on this game. I don't like using the 74U. So now, right now, again, I'm just playing for kills. I'm not really paying attention to anything because I already have my tactical nuke. Already accomplished what I wanted to get, you know, in this match. So I'm just gonna be having fun, just running around, slaying it out. That is exactly how you guys can set up a solo spawn trap on the map Shoot House. How you guys can get your streaks, your score streaks, your kill streaks a lot faster, and how you guys can potentially, you know, get your first tactical nuke. Hope this video did help you guys out, man. Let me know, like I said, down in the comment section right now, what map do you guys want to see me break down next? I think I might do Piccadilly next. It's kind of a bad map to kind of break down because there's a lot of camping that goes on. But I do want to help you guys out, and I want to help you guys improve on each and every map. I wanted to do kind of a how to spawn trap, or kind of how to do a solo spawn trap, or how to rotate the spawns on Shoot House first, because I feel like that's kind of the map that everybody plays, because everybody likes Shoot House. Because you're able to get a lot of kills, you know, get your camo challenges done and whatnot. So, like I said, keep a mental note. You guys might be able, like I said, drop your first tactical nuke and go crazy on this map. So, like I said, if you guys did enjoy, you guys want to see more map breakdowns, more gameplay breakdowns, stuff like that, make sure you guys absolutely smash like on the video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on those post notifications. And above all, everybody, make sure you have a great rest of your day. Deuces. If you made it this far into the video, odds are you enjoy the content or you are a very loyal subscriber, and I cannot thank you guys enough for your everlasting support. If you guys are unaware, every single night at 11:45 p.m. Central Time, and also every single morning at 11:15 a.m. Central Time, I am live streaming over on Twitch. On Twitch, I'm playing Modern Warfare with viewers, subscribers, anybody who wants to go ahead, interact with me, or run a couple games of Modern Warfare. You can go ahead and find my Twitch channel by searching in twitch.tv/earsxbl in the Google search bar, or going on Twitch and typing in earsxbl. My channel's gonna be the first thing that pops up. Make sure you guys go ahead and drop me a follow. We are on the road to 8,000 followers, as well as if you guys have Twitch Prime and want to hook your boy up, that'd be greatly appreciated. And if you guys do actually subscribe to the channel with Twitch Prime, or actually use a tier 1 sub, make sure you guys let me know over on Twitter. My link is going to be down in the description below. Tweet me a picture and I'll make sure to follow you guys back and give you guys a personalized thank you. Appreciate all the support you guys have been showing on the videos. You guys are absolutely amazing, and I hope to see as many of you guys over on the Twitch streams as possible. With all being said, I'm going to catch you guys in the next video. Deuces.